Hello there, my fellow brothers of the Firecast, and welcome back to another episode of Warhammer 40k Lore. Today, we're gonna be returning to the military of the greater good, and talk about some Tau battlesuits. Except in this case, it is not an actual battlesuit, but a stealth suit instead. And thus, today's more exact topic is the technically designated XV-15 stealth suit. Also, since there aren't a lot of pictures on this thing, I might also use some pictures of other stealth suits instead. I'm your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? In a nutshell, the XV-15 is the smallest of all Tau battlesuit variants, and it was designed for use in operation requiring a high degree of stealth. Who could have imagined that a stealth suit would be used in stealth missions, right? For a bit of history on this thing, it was on the Tau world of Dal'if Prime during the Damocles Gulf Crusade that XV-15 clad fire warriors were used to protect forward Pathfinder spotter teams during their missions to pinpoint targets for long-range seeker missile strikes. Their jetpacks and cloaking fields allowed them to respond quickly and effectively to most Imperial threats. The Kappa Mortis incident was an important event that contributed to the further development of stealth suits in general. An ultramarine force was sent to the planet of Kappa Mortis and managed to recover a single XV-15 helmet from a crashed lander bearing captured Tau technology. This, in turn, would force the Tau Earthcast to accelerate development on a new type of stealth suit as a result, rushing the single-weapon XV-25 stealth suit. Ironically, this caused the XV-15 stealth suit to become far less common in the Tau Hunter cadres, because they were being replaced as the standard stealth suit by the newer XV-25. During the Taros campaign, the deployment of XV-15 stealth suits was an important component of the overall Tau strategy. The stealth suit teams would be inserted behind enemy lines, where they would continually wreak havoc upon Imperial supply lines, causing food and water shortages for the Imperial forces on the front line. The XV-15s were used as part of the first deployment of a specialist stealth suit formation called a Night Hunter Stealth Group during the fighting against the Wasp Scarkill. The Orcs had captured an Imperial mining world, and they were using the human colonists as slave labor to collect the planet's rich deposit of iron ore. This ore would be used to begin the construction of a mob of Orc Stompas. The Tau found themselves hard-pressed to meet the Orcs in open battle. Instead, they attacked the mines, forcing the Greenskins on the defensive. In battle after battle, the Tau deployed their new Night Hunter formation. Each stealth group was inserted deep behind enemy lines or within the mine complexes themselves, using their stealth field generators to remain concealed. When the Hunter cadres attacked the Orcs in a more traditional manner, the stealth groups opened fire on the Orcs from behind, negating the benefit of any cover they might have. Out of 24 deployed groups, 8 of these were lost to Orc counterattack, but ultimately, Wasp Scarkill was defeated because of their efforts. Once again, during the Achilles Crusade in the Jericho Reach, the stealth teams of the Vel Concept were left behind on the worlds from which the Tau had withdrawn willingly. They were then used to confound Imperial forces that came to these worlds after the Tau withdrawal and gather strategic data on the strength and tactics of the humans. An XV-15 stealth suit is worn by a Firecast member who has attained the rank of Shasui, normally after they completed a tour of duty as the Shasui of a regular squad of fire warriors. The stealth suit team leaders hold the rank of Shasvrei, and they are masters of the arts of subterfuge. The entire squad is usually bonded to one another via the Tau custom of Talisera, which is symbolized by a knife design painted onto the squad leader's armor. An XV-15 stealth suit team usually consists of 3 to 6 members. These units operate in support of larger Tau formations, or range ahead independently from the Tau army. They are not factored directly into Tau battle plans due to the nature of their covert role in battle, and they enjoy a great deal of freedom of action and autonomy within very broad parameters which are set down by the Tau commanders. This freedom of action is actually quite rare in Tau military operations. That is because the stealth teams are encouraged to fight independently and use their own initiative in assaults, as befits their combat style and tactical specialization. Observing comm silence and unable to receive orders all the time, the stealth teams are typically left to make their own decisions. Those Shasui that volunteer for duty in a stealth team are seen as bizarre, an unpredictable lot who don't always follow convention. Those that survive long enough to earn the title of Shasvrei within a stealth suit team are without exception eccentrics among their fellow Tau, but also famous for their tactical innovation and daring raids behind enemy lines. An XV-15 stealth suit can operate in many different tactical roles, ranging from ambushing isolated enemy units when they least expected, to intervening in support of a friendly unit when required. In the reconnaissance role, stealth suits can infiltrate deep behind enemy lines, or move into a forward position unseen where they can assault enemy units while they are off guard. However, when an XV-15 stealth suit team operates behind enemy lines, they are not alone, and they can call in a plethora of support options to better aid them in their mission. The Shasvrei of a stealth suit team can be armed with a marker light and target lock, allowing them to designate an enemy target for a long-range seeker missile strike, and can also carry homing beacons to allow further battlesuit teams to accurately deploy in a devastating surgical strike. Some Tau septs, most notably the Tashvar, are known to employ stealth teams outfitted with marker drones. This is a common tactic against large orc armies, as the stealth teams use their burst cannons to thin the enemy numbers before painting them with their marker lights, allowing the rest of the main force to wipe them out. The Firecast doctrine laid down in the Code of Fire instructs all the warriors of such a team to fight closely together, with each member of a team doing their best to protect not just their comrades, but also other nearby teams of the cadre. Built from the same nanocrystalline alloy, Fiotak, as the larger XV-8 Crisis battlesuit, the XV-15 stealth capabilities make its wearer very difficult to detect, and its integrated burst cannon is the perfect weapon for ambushing lightly armored units and attacking the flanks of a vehicle. Its jetpack also gives the wearer the maneuverability required to redeploy quickly on the battlefield if the situation changes. The mobility provided by the jetpack also allows the wearer of an XV-15 stealth suit to pounce from cover upon the unsuspecting enemy and then retreat out of range again before they could retaliate. This, in turn, makes jetpack-equipped stealth suit teams very difficult to counter, and very difficult for the enemy to engage properly. Last but not least, the jetpack can be used to slow the stealth suit descent from a high altitude, allowing for a stealth team to be dropped directly behind enemy lines from high-flying transports like an Orca or a Manta. The XV-15 is only slightly more bulky than the standard combat armor worn by a Fire Warrior, and incorporates many of the standard features shared by many Tau battlesuits. The jetpack also allows the battlesuit to maintain a stable platform from which to fire the weapons, even when on the move. In addition to the jetpack, it also incorporates advanced sensors common to all Tau battlesuits built into the helmet. These sensors and systems allows for the user to gather more accurate battlefield data, which can assist in informed decision-making on where to best deploy themselves to maximize their tactical effectiveness. All XV-15s are also equipped with a Black Sun filter, which is an advanced optical system which magnifies the warrior low-light vision while simultaneously filtering out bright flares of light which could blind the pilot in battle. It also has a multi-tracker, which assists battlesuit pilots in engaging enemy threats by using multiple weapons at once. Even the shape of the armor can help deflect solid projectiles, while a reflective liquid metal coating can reflect medium-grade laser fire. The suit's integrated holographic disruption field achieves that effect through a number of disruptor emitter nodes arrayed all over the armor itself. This holographic disruption field operates in two modes. The default, passive mode utilizes a range of technologies to dampen the suit's electromagnetic signature so that enemy scanners are less likely to detect it. This mode is called passive because its use cannot be detected, as rather than attempting to interfere with enemy sensors, it only masks the suit itself. When in active mode, however, the stealth field generator comes online. The suit's matte finish ripples and blurs, resolving itself into a nigh-perfect representation of the terrain lying behind it. This makes the suit and its wearer all but transparent to visual identification. In this way, the form is blended into the background as if its wearer was a Terran chameleon. In addition, when operating in this mode, the stealth suit systems are actively interfering and jamming enemy sensor devices. In areas of cover, like a forest or the rubble of a city, they can effectively fade into the background, making themselves extremely difficult targets for enemies to mark out or to lock onto effectively. The main weapon of an XV-15 is a burst cannon integrated into the suit's upper arm. This benefits the stealth suit role, as the wearer can lay down a hail of suppressive anti-infantry firepower. It can also use the burst cannon to target the usually more vulnerable side or rear armor of a vehicle. The Chasse Vrai squad leader of a stealth team can take one item from a battlesuit armory to enhance their combat capability. Thus, the Chasse Vrai of an XV-15 team can be accompanied by two Tau drones in battle, whether they are gun drones or shield drones, to lend additional firepower or protection. These drones are also equipped with the same technology that the stealth suits use, allowing them to operate without compromising the stealth team's ability to remain undetected. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the XV-15 stealth suit for today. Ironically, this one isn't even the most advanced of the Tau stealth suits, as the XV-25 I mentioned is more or less superior. I didn't make a poll today, but if you guys would like another stealth suit in the future video, you can let me know in the comments. Otherwise, it'll probably be another battle suit. Are you folks fans of the XV-15? Did you even know about it prior to this episode? What do you like or dislike about it, or, why not, stealth suits in general? If you found the episode informative or entertaining, please click the like, share, and subscribe buttons for future content. Thanks a lot for watching to the end, and I wish you all a great and healthy day. For the greater good.